I like Adonis, you know, and I think he's a stand-up, you know, role model, but he's flawed, and I think that's what, you know, people like about him because he's real. But the physicality of it, you know, it's never easy getting back into like that shape, you know, especially after, you know, pandemic, this, that, you know, other things that are projects and stuff like that. So yeah, that's always difficult.
I spent the last 7 years of my life living out my wildest dreams. Bianca, Rocky, my dad, this is built on their shoulders.
Amigos de Estilo de F, el día de hoy estamos con Michael B. Jordan. Hi, Michael, how are you?
I'm doing good, how are you?
Good, thank you. Well, there's a lot of things to talk about, Creed 3. And let's start with the fact that today is your birthday and today is the premiere here.
It is.
Are you excited to be here?
Very excited, you know? I think, you know, first time, you know, my first time directing, that movie's premiering here, you know, spending my birthday here. It's great to have all those things happening, you know, on the same day.
For sure. And yeah, why did you decide to make your debut as a director with this movie?
I think it was as safe a space for me to direct, you know, as a character that I knew very well, as a franchise that I know very well. You know, the boxing, you know, I had a clear point of view. I know how to shoot the boxing and the fights. And, you know, I wanted to tell where Adonis was going, you know, and where his family was going. You know, I feel really connected to this franchise. So I felt like it was the perfect opportunity.
Hey, my man, can I help you?
Let me get an autograph.
No, I ain't signing the autographs, but you get off my car.
You don't remember me, huh?
Damien.
What was the most difficult thing that you had to do being the protagonist and also the director?
I think the toughest thing is just time management, you know, being able to, you know, just compartmentalize acting, directing, and sometimes they blend together. You know, I think that was a really big challenge for me in the beginning. But yeah, and then also just communicating with everybody. You know, I think there's so 200 people on a set, you know, all in very important jobs, you know, in order to make your vision come true. And you have to learn everybody's love language. You know, this person needs to be talked to? How do you talk to this person? So I think for me, you know, communication and becoming a great communicator was something that I definitely learned and I grew throughout.
Yeah. Did you have some tips for other directors?
Pray. I don't know. No. It's, you know, just prepare. You know, I think. You never have enough time. So, you know, before you actually get on set day one, make sure you've thought about as many things as you can and then have a backup plan to those things, you know, because things change all the time. But just be really prepared and to trust your gut. You gotta trust your instinct, you know, even though it feels like sometimes it may not be the right thing. Sometimes you just gotta see it through because now you know next time that you're in that position, you can make better decisions.
How long were you locked up?
18 years, bro. Just got out last week.
Glad to have you back out, man.
I know I've been away a long time, but I kept myself in shape. I still got gas in the tank.
Come by the gym.
Thank you.
What happened with you two?
I didn't tell you. We was like brothers. I was the best, though. Man, I never got a chance to prove that.
That's cute.
I know what you're doing, Donnie. You don't owe this to nothing.
And talking about your character, in this movie, your character is not a boxing anymore. It's more, it's a dad. It's more like a family man. Would you like to have that life in the future if you decide to stop acting?
What, a family?
Yeah, like the life that he was living.
I would love to have a family. You know, I think that's, you know, the natural progression. So yeah, I think, you know, for sure. Yeah.
Okay, and what is like your next project? Like, are you planning to continue directing things?
I would love to direct, you know, again, you know, I really, you know, enjoyed myself in this movie, in this franchise. And, you know, don't know what exactly that is, you know, but you could definitely look for things for me in the future for me to direct.
We will be waiting for that.
Okay, thank you so much.
And just tell me, was it difficult to go back to this character, talking about like physical preparation?
Maybe the physical preparation, but emotionally, no. You know, I like Adonis. You know, and I think he's a stand-up, you know, role model. But he's flawed, and I think that's what, you know, people like about him, because he's real. But the physicality of it, you know, it's never easy getting back into like that shape, you know, especially after, you know, pandemic, this, that, you know, other things that are projects and stuff like that. So yeah, that's always difficult, but well worth it.
Yeah, for sure. Well, the time is over, just on time. Okay. But thank you so much for your time.
No, thank you as well.
And congratulations for the movie.
Thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Damien was like family. We passed talking.
Then maybe you just have to find him.
I need you to let go of your fear. Let go of the guilt. Let go of whatever was and walk into what is.
I feel those chains are breaking, yeah. I fear God, I don't fear death. I see those stripes, I'm taking steps.